Bay, Washington. Teams taking drastic measures to save a young, ailing killer whale loaded up two boats with fat lip salmon as the sun rose Friday and rushed to waters off Washington State's San Juan Island, preparing if needed to test feed the critically endangered orca a day after injecting it with medicine. By early afternoon, it appeared the 3.5-year-old female orca called J50 was too far north in Canadian waters and any trial feeding effort would not happen. Brad Hansen, a wildlife biologist with the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration who is leading response efforts in the field, told reporters out on the water. For now, the unprecedented attempt to feed live salmon to a free-swimming killer whale would have to wait. The team led by the U.S. agency lacks a permit to feed the whale, which is emaciated and possibly suffering an infection, in Canadian waters, though it had one for medical treatment. NOAA would apply for the feeding permit if conditions are right, said Lynn Barr, NOAA Fisheries Recovery Coordinator for the whales. The agency wants to see whether it can deliver medication to the whale through live Chinook salmon but first needs to test whether the orca will take its preferred food source. With the whale far away and a bin full of salmon pulled that morning from a state hatchery, crews did a practice run to work out the logistics of feeding live fish to a whale while staying ahead of it in a boat. One by one, crews aboard a boat belonging to the Lummi Nation, an American Indian tribe, sent the pump salmon into a turquoise tube and then into the water. Researchers with the Whale Sanctuary Project practice taking samples of fish scales so they can later genetically track whether the whale consumed that fish. A King County research vessel drove alongside, also carrying fish, to provide support.
MW News, please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.